Good morning, students. I, Vijaya, your teacher of English, welcome you all to Rishikul Online School. Today, we are going to discuss Chapter 7, The Glimpses of India, and this is Part 3, Tea from Assam. And I welcome you to the Module 6 from the book First Flight. So come on, let's read. Tea from Assam. Chai garam, chai garam. A vendor called out in a high-pitched voice. He came up to their window and asked, Chai saab, give us two cups, Pranjal said. They sipped the streaming hot liquid. Almost everyone in their compartment was drinking tea too. Do you know that over 80 crore cups of tea are drunk every day throughout the world? Rajveer said. View, exclaimed Pranjal. Tea really is very popular. This chapter, Tea from Assam, is written by Arup Kumar Datta. Pranjal, a young boy from Assam, and Rajveer are classmates in a school in Delhi. Pranjal's father is a manager of a tea garden in Assam, and Rajveer is traveling to Assam along with Pranjal to spend his summer holidays with Pranjal's family. The train halts at a station. A vendor shouts, Chai garam, chai garam. The two boys order tea for themselves and enjoy sipping it. Almost all the passengers in the compartment are enjoying hot tea. Rajveer informs Pranjal that 80 crore cups of tea are consumed daily throughout the world. The train pulled out of the station. Pranjal buried his nose in his detective book again. Rajveer too was an ardent fan of detective stories, but at that moment he was keener on looking at the beautiful scenery. It was green everywhere. Rajveer had never seen so much greenery before. Then the soft green paddy fields gave way to tea bushes. In these lines, the writer Arup Kumar Gupta, he tells, as the train moves forward, Rajveer is excited to see the magnificent scenic beauty of the vast expanse of the tea estate. At the back, one can see dense hills, forest. In front of the hills, there was vast stretches of tea bushes. It was a magnificent view. Against the backdrop of densely wooded hills, a sea of tea bushes stretches as far as the eyes could see. Dwarfing the tiny tea plants were tall, sturdy shade trees. And amidst the orderly rows of bushes, busily moved doll-like figure. Here, paddy fields means a field where rice is grown. Backdrop means lie behind or beyond, serve as a background. Now see, Rajveer is thrilled to see the tea garden. However, it is a routine sight for Pranjal. Rajveer is excited to see the magnificent scenic beauty of the vast expanse of the tea estate. At the back, one can see dense hill forest, and in front, there was vast stretch of tea bushes, which was really a very good treat to his ears, to his eyes, to his ear because that voice was reaching near in his the distance ear. Was an ugly building with smoke billowing out of tall chimneys. Hey, a tea garden, Rajveer cried excitedly. Pranjal, who had been born and brought up on a plantation, didn't share Rajveer's excitement. He said, oh, this is a tea country now. He said, Assam has the largest concentration of plantation in the world. You'll see enough gardens to last you a lifetime. Here, billowing means moving or flowing outward. And concentration means cluster. Now, we will meet soon in the next module. Till then, bye-bye.